Okay, 6:10 p.m. It's Wednesday, July 9th, I think it is. What is it? 4th was on Saturday. 5th. Yeah, I think it's the 8th or 9th. Just gonna say, I got some more of these torch sunflowers. I think I'm gonna plant some more out here yet. I'm gonna spread them out along the border of that garden there. See, they're so thick here, I didn't realize when I planted them how they would come up. But next year I'm gonna have a row of sunflowers about 4 feet out from the garden, instead of right on top of it. It was a mistake also. I'll learn from that too. So this one here even will be out almost where CJ's headstone is there. Where's on, buddy? Petey? I just want to get these tomatoes on here. See, this is the one we had in the house. This tomato plant right here is the tallest one. And it was like that size when we brought it out. Again, I can't see good with this crack on the viewfinder. See, that's about 9 inches tall off the ground. And we bought this, these four right here from Kmart. And then we had hornworms or hookworm, whatever the heck it was, a big thick caterpillar on them. Petey, get off there, get off there. Yeah, they're coming back pretty good. This one here is the one that got the most damage from the worm. You see, we got a couple tomatoes on here. One there and one there. They got 2, 3, 4. Oh, there's another big one now that I didn't see that one. These are supposed to be beefsteak tomato plants. Heirloom. These four. Kmart. And this one here, the heirloom seeds I grew in the house, like I said. This looks like it's a beefsteak tomato also. That's a good size one there, about the size of a baseball. Again, I can't see. Right down there. There's one right next to it. Cool. And there's another one down there. Okay, so we got tomato plants coming up. I mean, tomatoes coming out on our plants. The giant bean is not coming up here. I planted two of them out here, and then I let one soak overnight about a month later. And I planted it down here. Nothing. Jackson Wonder bean. These two plants came out. I planted them at the same time. This one here is growing bigger. That's the second one. This one here is that Canelli heirloom bean that grew up after about a week. That's my buttercup scotch squash there and here. And then I forget what two of those are. Two different types though. There's three types of squash right here. And we have various peppers and tomatoes in here. This was going to be all a row of peppers and then two rows of tomatoes or three rows. But the tomatoes are growing so small. I mean, those grow good, but I still got a bunch of small ones. As you can see right here, see that tomato plant right there, how small that is. And I got one right there. Pepper plant, pepper. That's a tomato plant right here. Tomato plant, that one came up pretty good. See, these have been out here for about a week and a half, 2 weeks. That one's already 9 or 10 inches tall. Same thing with this one here. It's another tomato plant. And then we got pepper plant down in that little core right there. There's sunflowers over here. Purple hulls. I've been shelling black-eyed peas. I've been pulling these off. I don't know why that they're all turning yellow like this. There's eight places for black-eyed peas. They have usually two or three plants in each side of these cages. And like I said, this yellowing, I don't know if it's because of the water or what, but I've been picking these, let them dry out, and then shelling them. Been eating some raw ones. They're pretty good, actually. And then purple hull peas here. I've been picking these. See, these aren't totally purple. You don't want to pick those until they're all purple. I've got about two handfuls of those in the house. Someone's shooting out there. Little squash out here. Another thing, it seems like it's dying off. don't know why these leaves are doing this. I have to spray it. Here's my cantaloupe. I'm getting ready to take this in. Been out here looking like this for about a week. We can have to see. I think this is supposed to come off. It's yellow underneath. And there's 1, 2, 3 in there. If you see them all, there's 3 in there. And there's a little one down inside there. 3. So, well, here's one. Wow, there's a bunch right here. I didn't see this. See, here's one. Right here. 2, 3, 4, 5. See, now I'm thinking these are two different types. That's why. This is like a cantaloupe. This, I think, is a honeydew. It might just be smooth. So I'm hoping I get more cantaloupe over here somewhere. We got 5 of those sugar baby watermelons, those round ones. Look like bowling balls. And we got those elongated ones in the back garden there. Let me do this. I'll walk this way. Petey, stay off of here, the plastic. Go around. Go around. Yeah, see, this again, next year it'll be completely a lot better. Everything will be spaced out a little bit better. But the zucchini is slowing down a little bit. You got the golden zucchini in here. Picked a big green one yesterday. See the elongated watermelon here? You don't get them too big like this anymore. All they got some little round rinky-dink ones in the store like that right there. These are your traditional watermelons, you know, about 2 feet long. Pretty heavy. We already got one of those sugar babies in the house, and I got a video on to see them this season and whatnot. I'm get my deformed, perhaps possible Fukushima deformed sunflowers out here. See with the head coming out of the center of that one. There's like a double one there. That one's just deformed. That's a big heavy one right back there. This one here. One come out of the center of that one there. A lot of these got that little centerpiece coming out. So, what the reasoning is behind that, I've not seen it like that before. So many of them too. I mean, I don't grow sunflowers often, but when I have grown sunflowers, not probably about 7 to 10 of them, they're normal looking sunflowers. They look like that right there and that one there. When they come out like this and they got petals coming out of the middle of the head, well, that's a double head sunflower right there. That's the third one. You got stuff growing out of the center. We are attracting bees and butterflies over here. And that one right there, you see the bee on it? Another heavy head. These torch sunflowers are the ones they call them Mexican or torch sunflowers. It's the orange flowers. They're supposed to attract monarchs. They attract a bunch of butterflies, I'll say that much. Different colors. A lot of butterflies. And a lot of this stuff is getting pollinated as a result of that. We've been cutting okra off of here twice already today, and there's more pods on here, but I don't know if I'm going to cut them right now. See, that's kind of a small one right there. I don't see that one right there. Here's one that's good size, but I'll let that go till tomorrow if I can zoom in on it. Where's that? Anyway, they're about 2 inches long. When they're about 3 to 4, about 4 inches is perfect, I think. Some people say you don't want them that big, but you know, they all taste good to me. Lots of vitamins. Lots of vitamins and nutrients in these things. Yeah, see these right here? We got a lot of different butterflies out here. The big black, blue. See, look right here, there's one. See a couple of these right here all the time. You know, I get right up on them all. They don't fly away. You know, it's not uncommon to have about four of these, five of these out here, plus the little moth-like ones. And then, see, that's a moth one. And you get bees on them. And then soon we're going to take these heads off like this right here. It's where we get your seeds for next year. Each one of these you get hundreds of seeds off of. There's a moth on that one right there. But these are pretty. I really like these. I didn't know they would come out this nice. Next year, I'm going to spread them a little bit more. Put them here. Oh, that is such a pretty butterfly. I can find it. Who's that? It's a pretty butterfly. They say that these attract monarchs, but I haven't seen a monarch. I've seen a few of them that are that kind of color pattern. But I want to attach more of these down here, and I want to go down this side here. But I'm going to come out, like I say, 4 feet from the edge of the plastic. So this one, well, actually a little more on this one, it'll be close to the headstone here we have. And then over here, same thing, it'll be a little bit offset from this one. Then we have like a 4 foot walkway in between the gardens. So this is garden one, garden two over there, and garden three on the back. Everything's coming up pretty good. They were like dying off and they're coming back, those purple pole beans right there. The tomatoes are doing all right, peppers. Peppers along the house over there. There's 20 pepper plants. They're all coming up pretty good. My Swiss chard right here. Yep, so overall, the garden has produced more than we really, 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 really could have imagined. So, but now, you know, just get these tomatoes in here. Probably another week, I'll have my first fried green tomato out from out here. Hopefully, it'll be off my plant from here, and not the ones from Kmart. I mean, these are coming up with tomatoes, but look, like I said, I got two in there right now. And like, these grew from as small as that one right down there. That's how small it was when I put it out here. You see previous video of it. That was the one, first one I put down right there in the corner. And look at how big it is now. That's at least four and a half feet tall. And the ones from Kmart, well, you see those. They look like they haven't gotten any taller. They're just real, real full. And I'm almost wanting to say that's where I got the damn hookworm, the hornworm from. Because they were on the second one. I don't know, the first one and the third plant. And then I saw some on the fourth plant. I had four one day. Got them off. Then I had two on that back one. I had one on my plant. And then I had a smaller one that was on the second plant here. But I got them off. Now, you know, I'm just giving a visual look at them right now, so you can't really see them easy as it is, but I can see that there's none on here right now. And later today or tomorrow, probably tomorrow, I'm going to tie this up a little bit more on the stake in here. See, I should have put a tall one. This is a four-foot stake. These right here, these are about 3.5 feet. That'd be good if I just tie it one more time up on that one. Hummingbirds are doing really good. You know, we're going through last month we went through 50 pounds of sugar making the hummingbird feeders, filling them. You know, there's six out front. That one we don't even fill up no more. Bees were in that all the time. But this one here, and there's a big one like this on the front porch with the smaller ones. And on the back porch we had one, which I don't think we filled that one up anymore. I mean, you know, come on now, 50 pounds of sugar in a month is a lot of sugar. But I told my wife, cut back on it. Instead of putting a whole cup of sugar to 4 cups of water, I said put in 3/4 of a cup and see if they'll take it that way. And they're eating it fine like that. But, you know, too little, too late. But like I said, we're not going to be doing that no more like that. We just bought one 25-pound bag of sugar at the beginning of the month, and we'll cut it back accordingly. We got a lot of hummingbirds out here. We got lots of bees, lots of butterflies. And the cucumbers have been putting out like crazy. And the cucumbers right there in the middle. So, that's the garden. I figured I'd let Joe. Joe's got tomatoes in his place in Anna, Illinois. And I'm just showing you how mine look like here. And this first one here has just got the two. I just see this small one right here. And then the little bigger one right there. And I don't know if I see any other right off the bat. I don't really see one right now. Oh yeah, right there. I don't know if you can see that. And there's a small one down. Yeah, actually, I see like three or four small, real tiny ones. A couple on that other tomato plant right down there. Okay, so that's what they look like. And it'd be cool if you could get a video camera, Joe, and film your tomato plants and just see what they look like.